Hello, friends. A very happy Free Lesson Friday to all of you out there around the world on the internets. My name is Anthony Stauffer. I am, of course, your officially certified guitar instructor at stevysnacks.com. And I'm happy to report to you today that this is going to be my very last lesson. And I should probably finish that sentence by saying my very last lesson that I produce from my basement studio. You might have noticed that I missed last week's lesson. That's because I was moving most of my stuff into a little office space studio where I'll be doing all my work from now. So yay, I don't have to be down in my basement anymore. Didn't mean to have you worried there. Of course these lessons are going to keep coming and they're just going to get better. Today we're going to take a look at that little box three lick that I played there. Followed by... For those of you that are a little bit more advanced and you're just itching to get going, I'm just going to play the lick a couple of times, a little bit slower speed. That way you can just kind of knock yourself out trying to get it from just watching. And then I'll go through and I'll explain all the notes for those of you who need a little bit more explanation as to where and when this lick takes place. So let's take a look at that a little bit slower. Quite as advanced. Let's explain when this lick happens and a little bit more about what's going on and what we're doing with the specific notes. First of all, this lick will fit over bar 5 of the progression. So take a standard 12 bar sequence ending with the turnaround of the progression before it. That's bar 1 over the 1 chord, and sometimes the jump up to the 4 for the second bar. Back down to the 1 for bar 3, and again on the 1 for bar 4. Now we're going into bar 5, and that's your telltale sign when you hear it walking up into the 4 chord. That's when you would go. That's when this happens. Now let's talk about what tricks we're using here. Now you know when I teach my 5 boxes, I don't really teach scales. So up in this position, I've got this mutated little shape that I call the BB King box. But if you've taken my 5 Essential Blues Boxes course or my Essential Fretboard course, I talk about this little trick where you can take box 1, that little shape that everybody knows down here, and when you go over the 4 chord, you can actually slide this up here to where the root note matches the root note of the 4 chord. So you have that little trick that's kind of overlapped with the... And so they kind of, you can steal notes out of all of them, and that's kind of what we're doing here. So the first thing that we do... We're more using that sliding box 1 trick. So we're going to slide up here. I'm going to slide up here approximately, I think it's the 9th fret. And if you go up to the 10th, it's no big deal. And then go right up here to the 8th fret of the E string. We're just going to walk down this this shifted box 1 shape. So 8 on the E string, then 11 on the B string, 8 on the B string. And then slide here on the G string from 11 to 10. dropped a 8 on the G string, and drop down here to 10 on the D string. And then right back up here to 8 on the G string, and then bend up on 10 on the G, up to 8 on the E, and then down here, 8 on the G string. So you put that part together, that's like the first lick. And then you wait for like the start of bar number 6. And then you go. All right, let's get into that one little part at a time. So now you're definitely going to distinctly slide to 9 on the, almost you were like you were playing an E form 4 chord here. So you're going to slide to the major third of that chord, which happens to be right here in box 3. So you're going to slide from 8 to 9, or slide from way down up to 9 on the G string, follow through on 8 up from B to E, and 11 on B down to 8 on B. So you're going to do that nice little circle there. Then we're going to walk down. You know how sometimes we do, we're actually not going to do any of those hammer on pull off things. We're going to go. So we're going to walk down 11, 10, boy, I wish I could count, 10, 9, 8. And then do 3 of those in a row. Where we're going from 11 on B up to 8 on the E. And then after you do your third one, then you're going to walk down again. And then you're going to finish with 11 to 8 on the B. And then you can do one of two things. You can either do 10 on the G string, up to 8 on the B string, or 9 on the G string and up here. The difference is that if you do this, you're more using the box, shifted box 1 trick, but then you're ending on the root of the 1 note, since that's where we're going next. Because we transition back down to the 1 chord in bar number 7. So if you do this, it kind of gives it a little bit of a minor feel to it as you go back into that root note. But if you go, it kind of gives it more of a major sound. So let me just play it both ways so you can tell the difference. Here's with the minor. And here's with the more major sound. It's very subtle, but you essentially have 2 licks that you can use, just depending on which note you use there. So anyway, I'll play it again in slow motion here for you at the end, but I went through all the notes there. You should be able to get it. Once again, a reminder, this happens right as you go into bar 5, so after you get through the first 4 bars in here, right as you get there, wait for that beat. And that's where that will fit in a 12-bar blues progression. Now, if you really want to get advanced and you want to mess around with the timing a little bit, I'm not just playing all my notes at the same separation apart. Listen to where there's, I'm going to try and exaggerate some of the timing differences here. There, I took my time. And then I sped up at the end. So if I increase the contrast of what I'm doing there even more, you'd get something like. The important thing is that you make it all fit so that that hits on the, as you're going back to the 1 or halfway through the beat or something like that. So, I mean, that might be a little bit more advanced than what you need right now. Getting the notes is tough enough. I guess I should show the picking here so you can see what I'm doing. So here's the picking as we slide into the first part. And then the second part. Let's try that again. Here's the first part. And then the second part. So you can see there's some. There's some alternate picking going on, but I'm not too religious about how I do it. I have more of a just get it done approach. So anyway, that's that pretty cool Stevie Ray Vaughan box 3 lick. I hope you manage to fit it into your own playing and have some fun with it next time you're playing a song like Texas Flood or some other slow blues tune. And until next time, thank you very much for watching.